nothing. There's nothing that I care to choose to tell. You've been acting most peculiar. Every morning you're awake ahead of me. Always sitting by the window. I like to watch the river meet the sea.
Julie, I've been busting to tell you something lately.
You have?
The reason I didn't care to tell you before was 'cause you didn't have a feller of your own. But now that you got one, I can tell you about mine.
I'm glad you've got a feller, Carrie. What's his name?
His name is Mr. Snow, and an upstanding man is he. He comes home every night in his round-bottomed boat with a net full of herring from the sea. An almost perfect beau, as refined as a girl could wish. But he spends so much time in his round-bottomed boat that he can't seem to lose the smell of fish. The first time he kissed me, a whiff of his clothes knocked me flat on the floor of the room. But now that I love him, my heart's in my nose, and fish is my favorite perfume. Last night he spoke quite low, and a fair-spoken man is he.
And he said, "Miss Pipperidge, I'd like it fine if I could be wed with a wife. And indeed, Miss Pipperidge, if you'll be mine, I'll be yours for the rest of my life." Next moment we were promised, and now my mind's in a maze. For all I can do is look forward to that wonderful day of days. By the ocean side, where the salty breezes blow.
You and Mr. Snow,
he'll carry me across the threshold, and I'll be as meek as a lamb. Then he'll set me on my feet, and I'll say kind of sweet, "Well, Mr. Snow, here I am." Right as right can be.